Hello, I'm Dr. Aley Kalapila from Emory University. In this national HIV curriculum mini-lecture, I'm going to provide you with a brief review on the disease process called progressive multifocal leukoencephalopathy, which I will refer to by the abbreviation PML. So this is going to be the outline of my talk. I will start with some background, followed by reviewing clinical manifestations and how you make a diagnosis of PML. I will then discuss how to manage PML disease, followed by a summary. Now let's dive right into background. So PML is an opportunistic infection of the central nervous system. It is a focal demyelinating disease that is caused by the reactivation of the John Cunningham virus, or JC virus, in individuals who have advanced immunosuppression. So this is typically a CD4 count less than 200. Now, PML can also occur during immune reconstitution from ART initiation. About 20 to 70% of individuals from around the world have previously been exposed to the JC virus, but in general, with the widespread use of combination antiretroviral therapy to treat HIV, the rates of PML in people living with HIV have drastically decreased. Now let's discuss clinical manifestations and diagnosis of PML. Typically, the clinical manifestation of PML is focal neurological deficits based on the site of the brain lesion. This usually happens with an insidious onset, and there is a steady progression of deficits that worsen over time as the brain lesions expand. Now, remember that since these demyelinating lesions can often involve different brain regions, different patients will have a variety of neurological deficits based on the location of those demyelinating brain lesions. In general, headache, fever, acute encephalopathy are not really commonly seen with PML. Seizures can occur in about 20% of patients with PML, and they typically occur due to brain lesions that are adjacent to the cortex. On occasion, the presenting symptoms due to focal brain lesions may be mistaken for a stroke, but the progressive nature of the disease process should point away from a stroke diagnosis. Now, PML disease can affect any part of the central nervous system except the spinal cord and optic nerves. Typically, there is usually just one lesion that drives the symptoms, but on occasion, you can see multiple brain lesions with PML. In general, a diagnosis of PML is typically made presumptively based on the clinical syndrome and neuroimaging. So, with symptoms, as I mentioned previously, patients will typically exhibit slowly progressive neurological deficits, and on imaging, you'll have MRI findings demonstrating distinct white matter lesions in areas of the brain corresponding to the clinical deficits. These PML brain lesions appear as hyperintense or white on T2-weighted and flare sequences, as seen in the image shown on this slide. While you can presumptively make a diagnosis using the clinical symptoms and neuroimaging, you can confirm or verify the diagnosis, especially for an atypical case, by doing a lumbar puncture and sending off the CSF for PCR testing for JC virus DNA. Now, if the CSF analysis is negative, but your clinical suspicion for PML remains high, you can repeat the CSF analysis again and repeat the JC virus PCR test on the CSF, provided, of course, you have excluded alternative diagnoses. Brain biopsy can be used to definitively diagnose PML, but as you can imagine, this test is rarely done given how invasive the procedure is. Let's now talk about some details on the management of PML. The cornerstone of managing PML is immune reconstitution, or in other words, to reverse immunosuppression. And this, of course, is done by starting antiretroviral therapy as soon as possible. There is no specific antiviral or immunomodulatory treatment that is recommended to treat PML. Now, if a patient is on an ART regimen with an undetectable HIV viral load, there is no role for intensifying an ART regimen, adding more antiretroviral drugs in order to treat PML. There have been many drugs considered as potential candidates to treat PML, including cytarabine, cidofovir, some antipsychotics, etc. but there have been no medications that have been shown to mitigate disease progression in controlled clinical trials, and hence, no other medication aside from a fully active ART regimen is recommended for the treatment of PML. With regard to outcomes with a PML diagnosis, the one-year survival is approximately 60%. Neurological deficits often persist. Some case series indicate that a worse prognosis is associated with having a high plasma HIV RNA at the time of diagnosis and/or having a poor virologic response to ART and/or presence of brainstem lesions. There are two types of immune reconstitution inflammatory syndrome, or IRIS, that you can see with PML. The first is an unmasking of occult or cryptic PML. So this is where patients may be asymptomatic or have very mild symptoms that are not picked up on when antiretroviral therapy is initiated. They start taking their ART, and then they experience immune reconstitution, and with that, they start to have worsened symptoms, which now represent an unmasking of that underlying PML diagnosis. This is thought to be due to a restored immune response to JC virus, leading to local immune and inflammatory responses. Or there are also people that have a known diagnosis of PML who are then started on antiretroviral therapy, and then with immune reconstitution, they exhibit a paradoxical worsening of their symptoms. PML IRIS is more common in patients with a very low CD4 count who have a large decline in their HIV viral load with ART initiation. Corticosteroids may be used when patients have cerebral edema or mass effect that can cause rapid clinical deterioration, but the optimal dosage and duration of corticosteroids has not been determined, so the HHS opportunistic infection guidelines recommend tailoring the steroid plan to the patient. MRI neuroimaging can be obtained approximately 2 to 6 weeks out, and this can be used to monitor disease progression or improvement, but the ART should not be stopped. ART must be continued regardless of the severity of the PML IRIS symptoms. So in review, PML is a demyelinating disease of the central nervous system, which is caused by the JC virus in individuals with HIV and advanced immunosuppression. A diagnosis is typically presumptive based on clinical symptoms and neuroimaging. You can use CSF analysis, specifically doing a CSF PCR for JC virus, in order to confirm or verify a diagnosis. The mainstay of treatment for PML is effective antiretroviral therapy. Neurological deficits seen with PML may be permanent. If PML IRIS occurs, corticosteroids can be used to manage severe symptoms seen with cerebral edema or mass effect, and ART should be continued regardless of PML IRIS.
The production of this National HIV Curriculum Mini-Lecture was supported by grant U10HA32104 from the Health Resources and Services Administration of the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services. Its contents are solely the responsibility of the University of Washington IDEA Program and do not necessarily represent the official views of HRSA or HHS.